Chairwoman Mikulski, Ranking Member Shelby, and distinguished members of the Senate Appropriations Committee, thank you for the opportunity to testify today on the U.S. Department of State and USAID emergency request for assistance to combat the ongoing Ebola epidemic. I'm pleased to be accompanied by Nancy Limborg, USAID Assistant Administrator for the Bureau of Democracy, Conflict, and Humanitarian Assistance, who is helping to lead USAID's response on the ground. Madam Chairwoman, I have submitted to the committee a detailed statement for the record, and in the interest of time, I will briefly summarize my statement here. The Ebola epidemic in West Africa has already resulted in over 14,000 Ebola-infected persons and over 5,000 deaths. While Liberia, Sierra Leone, and Guinea have borne the brunt of the epidemic, we have also seen cases in Mali, Nigeria, Senegal, and Spain. And of course, isolated cases in the United States highlight the U.S. national security implications of this epidemic. The Department of State and USAID are working in concert with agencies represented at this hearing today and alongside our global partners to stop the spread of the Ebola virus at its source. The State and USAID strategy to eradicate Ebola in West Africa rests upon four pillars: controlling the epidemic, managing the secondary consequences of the outbreak, building coherent leadership and operations, and ensuring global health security. State and USAID have taken immediate action within existing resources to begin implementing the strategy. USAID deployed a disaster assistance response team, or a DART team, to lead the U.S. response on the ground in all three affected countries. Secretary Kerry created an Ebola coordination unit to drive our diplomatic efforts to raise international contributions. Over $1 billion in bilateral commitments and nearly $800 million in commitments to the UN have already been made. As a result of these efforts, alongside those of our colleagues across government, we are beginning to see results. But it is important to recognize that the epidemic is not yet controlled and that the number of cases will continue to grow. It's clear that we must intensify and scale our efforts to eradicate the epidemic, and to do so will require additional resources. The Department of State and USAID are jointly requesting $2.9 billion to end the epidemic at its source in West Africa, including $2.1 billion in base funding to meet immediate needs and $792 million in contingency funding to address emerging requirements as the epidemic evolves. $1.3 billion in base funding will be directed to the first pillar of our response strategy, controlling the outbreak. These resources will support the construction, staffing, and operation of up to 20 Ebola treatment units and establish and staff up to 150 community care locations in rural and hard-to-reach areas in the region. This funding will also be used to scale up contact tracing, train and mobilize healthcare workers and safe burial teams, and replenish vital logistics and supplies, including personal protective equipment. Our base request also includes $388 million to support the second pillar of our response strategy, mitigating second-order impacts. Ebola has decimated the health systems infrastructure within these three countries and has wreaked havoc on local economies. We are particularly concerned about food security. The USAID-funded Famine Early Warning Systems Network has issued an alert that a major food crisis is expected to occur in 2015 if the epidemic proceeds through March. Our funding request seeks to counter these destructive consequences, which, if left unchecked, will undermine our efforts to combat Ebola at its source and could create instability in the region. Our base request includes $77 million to support the third pillar of our response strategy, coherent leadership and operations. These funds are critical to expanding the department's medical support and evacuation capacity in the region and for supporting key diplomatic operations such as the Ebola Coordination Unit and the USAID staff engaged in the Ebola response. Finally, our base request for the fourth pillar of the strategy, ensuring global health security in West Africa, includes $62 million to support pandemic preparedness and strengthen public health systems in Liberia, Sierra Leone, and Guinea, and $278 million to prevent the spread of Ebola to other vulnerable nations through the global health security agenda. In sum, our emergency request will allow state and USAID to scale up our existing efforts across all pillars of the response strategy. We are seeing some promising signs on the ground, but it is clear that the epidemic is not yet controlled. These resources are imperative to eradicating the Ebola outbreak at its source, which is the most effective way of protecting Americans here at home. Thank you for your time, and I look forward to your questions.